What's happening in America, North, Central, and South? What's happening in Europe, Africa, Asia? That one guy in Antarctica freezing his ass off, and of course, the wonderful people of Australia. I will always be grateful to you guys for giving us not only Hugh Jackman, but the pinnacle of human physical perfection, Margot Robbie. Thank you so much. Before I go on, I think it's important that I mention Salwete is how you say hello in Latin. Now, don't get too excited, Jeff Sessions. You're probably sitting there thinking, well, good golly, what a convenient lesson to learn. Honey, grab the maracas. I know how to speak to the Mexicans now. No, that's not what it means, Jeff. I'm not talking about a culture of people. I'm talking about a language. A language that's basically not used anymore ever. Well, unless you're listening to an opera, which is, I'm thinking, one of the only times you're going to ever use Latin. Then again, let's not gloss over the small but possible chance that you might run into a giant group of Roman ghosts, in which case, you're welcome. Salwete! As they all stab you a million times, because of course you're going to run into the group that killed Caesar, and that's how it's going to go. It's a fine, scorching day in South Florida. The 10th circle of hell, people. That's where we're at. Only it's humid, which is something that I don't think is actually a thing in hell, as far as I know from the scriptures, which honestly is not much at all, anything whatsoever. But, you know, I don't think they ever mentioned that hell was a humid place, meaning Miami is like a step deeper. There's hell and then there's Miami. Not only are you on fire, but you also look like you just crawled out of someone's armpit 24/7. As soon as you step outside, just this layer of like almost sci-fi alien cocoon looking shininess spreads over you. And then you just, okay. You start walking on the sidewalk, just super tired. Walk a few blocks, get like a mile away from your house, and that's when you see a guy just walking down the street, agua! Agua por $3! ¿Quién quiere agua? And suddenly you think, is this how murder happens? Because I'm suddenly really okay with just throwing this guy into traffic so I can get one of those bottles of water. Oh, God. All right, and then you start just like tasting the sweat drip into your mouth, and you're thinking, that's salty water, that's something. It's okay. You fall to the ground, looking up at the blue sky, as that sunlight just fries you like an ant on the pavement, and then a shadow comes over you. Is that an eclipse? No, it's a person. And they bend down with a wooden bowl of water? Yes, that is water, and you drink just... Oh, God. Oh, thank you. And you look up at the silhouette of your savior. This being from another realm that came down to earth just to save you. And you go, Jesus? And he leans closer and says, Mijo, por favor, soy yo, Walter Mercado. Oh, that explains it. I was like, why does Jesus look like Liberace? I should have never brought you water, you ungrateful bitch. Jesus, Walter. The hell, man, I'm dehydrated. I don't know what I'm saying. Calm down. Can we start fresh here, huh? What do you say? Let's start over, okay? Okay, let's be friends. Fine. Hello, my name is Ramses. Nice to meet you. Now you say your name. But you know my name. Wait, would you just play along, please?
Hello, I am Walter. It is nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Thank you.
It's very nice to meet you. I like what you're wearing. I do. I dig the whole look. It's very like grandma meets the killers.
I'm going to put a curse on you as soon as I get home.
I deserve it. I had kind of a weird morning today. I decided to go out to the library and get some books to study up on some things I'm working on. And right off the bat, started the day off with a strange interaction with somebody. Nothing big, just a little small, weird thing. I'm paying my library fees, which, side note, makes me very happy that I never asked anyone in the mafia for help, because I'd be doing this podcast from a wheelchair. Those fees, baby! I gotta return those books on time. The point is, I went to get these two new books, and the guy said, oh, you have these fees you have to pay. I said, all right, I'll just pay them right now and get them out of the way. And I pay, and then he's like, all right, let me give you your change. And he reaches out, and I'm like, all right, I stretch out my hand to get the change. My hand is right, like, next to his. He sees it and puts the change down on the counter, which is one of the more quiet ways of telling somebody you think they're diseased. That's basically how I took that. I thought he saw my hand and was like, no chance, buddy. I saw you when you walked in here, looking all clammy, sweaty. I know West Nile virus when I see it, pal. You got the Zika, okay? So why don't you do us both a favor and get your walking dead ass out of here so I can start dousing this counter in alcohol before you kill us all. Okay, Dead Zone? What are you waiting for? What do you want?
I'm just waiting for my receipt.
Oh, sure. There you go. Have a nice day. So I leave the guy in the hazmat suit, and I go on to get a coffee, because I'm thinking, all right, I got my books, I want to study, but like a lot of Americans, I think, I need a little something. Need a little something extra. Since I'm not a big fan of LSD, I thought, coffee. So I'm driving to the closest Cuban bakery to my house, and as I'm walking in, I notice a lady trying to come into the shop as well, and I hold the door open for her, as a gentleman does, and then she walks in, and I get the ticket for me, and I walk up to the counter. And one of the employees comes up, looks at us, and goes, all right, who's first? And I show her my ticket, and she looks at me and takes the lady's order. It was weirder than that, because she came up, said, who's next? I said, me, and then she heard me say my order. She waited for that. And then as soon as I was done, she turned to the lady, asked her what she wanted, and then just did her order instead. It was a mix of emotions. It was weird. On one hand, I was trying hard not to laugh. On the other, I was trying hard not to be pissed. Although I will admit, I was more mad than laughing. At the time, because to me, I was just thinking, why would she even ask who's next? Why would she do that? Why'd she walk up? She basically did this. She walked up, went, who's next? You? Mm-hmm. No. Ma'am, what do you want instead? So I get my coffee eventually, and I go get in the car, start driving back into the Sahara Desert. And as I'm cruising down the road, noticing all the people around me and all their cars, the different makes and models, different brands. And I suddenly think, you know, a car says a lot about the person who's driving it. But mainly all it says is, this person cares a lot about their car. And that's all. I never understood people who get super into, I mean, a lot of guys will tell you, no, we just like cars because chicks like cars, bro. That's why you gotta get a wicked awesome car, so that the chicks would be like, what? And then they'll get in the car with you, and like, you can go to Bonnaroo. I don't know what the... I never cared. To me, a car is just the thing that gets me from one place to another. I want it to work, I want it to be comfortable, and I would prefer it to be new only because that means there's a guarantee that nobody had sex in the car. That's I don't know why, it's just one thing that kind of weirds me out. If I get in a used car, somebody's bare ass was just thumping all around this thing. Nah. See, here's what I would do. If I were filthy rich, here's what I would do. I'd get a nice car. I don't know if I'd get a luxury vehicle, but I'd get something that I think is enough of what I want when I say comfortable and reliable. And then what I would do is I would make it so that the outside of this car basically looks like a dumpster. I would just make it look like it's been through hell, like it's been robbed 3 times and then like left in a swamp or an alligator shit all over it. And that's what I would drive that. So from the outside, it's a steaming pile of garbage. But when you get in, it's just great. It's great. It's a nice car. And on the outside, it looks like a turd on wheels. That's what I would do. Because then no one would rob my car. No one would want to rob my car. There's no... Where's the selling value? If it has tinted windows, they can't see inside. They can't see the nice bits. All they'll see is the outside that looks like somebody threw a Molotov cocktail at it. And then 35 more Molotov cocktails. I want a car that would be fitting in a horror story. I want people to be able to create legends about my car.
Yes, sir, that's the one. That's the car that had a whole family burning alive inside it for 3 weeks.
Goddamn. 3 weeks?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. Maybe more. By the way, did you know that I learned the language of the Mexicans? Jeff, that's Spanish, dude. We talked about this. Also, there's more Hispanic people than just Mexicans. You know that, right?
Good golly, that's amazing. I just started learning Latin yesterday, and I already understand him perfectly.
I'm speaking English, Jeff, and I'm not even Mexican.
Oh, yes, of course, of course. Espiritu Santo, amen.
Forget it. Why do I even try?
Point is, I want a car that can be incognito in the world. Look like garbage on the outside, be just perfect on the inside. Exactly what I need. I don't care about how it looks.
I really don't. I mean, and that's not to say I don't think some cars look cool. They do. I think a lot of cars look cool. I don't have that hunger that some of my friends have when they look at those kinds of cars. They're just like, I just need one, dude. Oh my God, I just need a Ferrari, dude. That's how you know you've made it. When you have a Lamborghini, dude, that's how you know you've made it. I don't know if having a Lamborghini is how you know you've made it, but that's how I would know that my bank account is about to go bye-bye. That's what that would say. Not just because the car is expensive, but because what I see when I see a Lamborghini is a car that hasn't been stolen yet. That's all I see. I see a car that hasn't been stolen yet and or hasn't cost the owner thousands of dollars to repair yet. Because those, I mean, it's super flashy. That's the whole thing. Buying an expensive car isn't buying an expensive car. It's an investment from a bunch of different angles after the fact. You have that car, now you know you gotta pay valet. You're not gonna park that shit in a CVS parking lot. You're not gonna leave your McLaren F1 parked a block away from the shady looking bar. Don't give me that crap. Don't give me that. No one's giving me that crap. But just in case, don't give me that crap. I don't believe it. Having an expensive car means as soon as you step out of it, you are now in a Jason Bourne movie, automatically. That's why all these people who have like super luxury cars have to have a driver. Cause they can't just park it. They can't just leave it there. They'll come back and find their steering wheel. And not even with the logo in it, it'll just be the wood just stripped raw. It doesn't make sense. I don't see the point. It could make sense to some people. If you're rich enough, you don't give a shit. Everything makes sense, even if it costs $5 million. But I don't see the point, really. The only time I see the point in having an expensive car is when you are at the certain level of broke where it's like, all right, things aren't looking too good at work. I don't have many prospects. I might lose it all. So I should spend as much as I can afford to on a car because chances are in a month, I'm going to be living in it. Let's get real. That's going to be my house. So I should invest as much as I can because now I'm investing in my apartment on wheels. That's the only time I think it makes sense to really splurge on a car. I don't know. That's just me, people. And this is just me saying thank you for listening to another episode of Oops, Wrong Hole. That's it for today. I am Ramses Ravicast, bidding you a farewell. Feel free to follow me on all the social medias, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, all those things, baby. Why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you? It's the one place where you can follow me and I can't call the cops on you. That's Ravacast. Have a good night, everybody, and a pleasant tomorrow. Hasta la bye-bye.